clean his section up here. But praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the
Lord. Praise Hallelujah. The Lord.
I think this is my first time in the pulpit since, in our pulpit since yeah, my initial sermon. So y'all pray with me and pray for me. I tell you that the devil's been fighting, been fighting for weeks, and then come Monday, I'm congested and throat hurt and laying on his chest, coughing and sniffling. And but I tell you, God is truly God. God is truly able. Today, I'm going to be speaking from Exodus chapter 8, verse 16 through 19. Thought we'd do a little Old Testament here. Exodus 8, chapter 16 through 19. And the word of God says, "So the Lord said to Moses, tell Aaron, raise your staff and strike the ground. The dust will turn into swarms of gnats throughout the land of Egypt." So Moses and Aaron did just as the Lord had commanded them. When Aaron raised his hand and struck the ground with his staff, gnats infested the entire land. And I'm reading from the NLT version. Covering the Egyptians and their animals, all the dust in the land of Egypt turned into gnats. Pharaoh's magicians tried to do the same thing with their secret art, but this time they failed. And the gnats covered everyone, people and animals alike. Verse 19, "This is the finger of God," the magicians exclaimed to Pharaoh. But Pharaoh's heart remained hard, and he would not listen to them, just as the Lord had predicted. I want to talk to you today from the subject of often imitated, but never duplicated. Tap that power. Father God, we come before you now, God. God, first off, I want to tell you, thank you, God. Thank you, God, for keeping us. Thank you for waking us up this morning. Thank you for being God. God, I ask right now that you will move Chrishonda out of the way, God. God, and speak through me, God. God, so that the words that you have to say may bless someone, God, as you bless my soul with this word, God. Help me to portray your words as you need them to come forth, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I do not plan to be before you long. I'm going to try to control my voice because when I get loud, I start coughing. So I'm not going to be before you long. We all know the story of Pharaoh and Moses and the children of Israel. We all know this. We've grown up hearing it. Bedtime stories, whatever you want to call it. Pharaoh had the children of Israel in captivity. He wouldn't let them go. See, Pharaoh thought that he was the all, to all, be all. He thought he was God. But God had to show him through Moses and Aaron. God gave Pharaoh six opportunities to let the children go. But as God said in Exodus 7, that he will make Pharaoh's heart hard. Because why? He needed to multiply his signs and wonders in Egypt that they would know that he was God and not Pharaoh. Often imitated, but never duplicated. See, when Obama was elected, and this is why I say, well, Pastor was all over my subject this morning. When Obama was elected, we all went through, we thought he was going to be, you know, the it. You know, because he was the first African-American, you know. And don't get me wrong, I am not knocking it at all. I thank God for allowing me to live, to see history made. Our ancestors fought for that. But everybody thought that Obama was going to be the one to rescue the country. He was going to be the one to save us. You know, the economy was going to pick up. You know, we got an African-American president. Power to the people. But is the country in any better shape than what it was before he took over?
No.
Because why? Obama was not the savior. I am that I am is the savior. Often imitated. Politicians lie. People lie to us. They make empty promises. But God is still God. You cannot duplicate God. Nine plagues. Count them. I counted them. I was up last night making sure my count was right because I didn't want to, you know, get ahead of God. Nine plagues took place before Pharaoh let the children go. Even then, he still didn't fully let them go. God just allowed the children to get a head start so that God could display his ultimate power, his ultimate act of power to Pharaoh and some of the Israelites just in case they were still little in captivity, and their mind was still in captivity. Pharaoh's magician gave up on copying God. And if you would look back at the scripture, it said because they knew that the finger of God was on them. And then therefore, they couldn't copy that. They never said the hand of God. They just said his finger. Now think about it. Later on in the scriptures, God brought down his hand. But in the beginning, they talked about the finger being on God. They knew that they could not copy God. They knew that they were no match for his power. Exodus 6 and 1. Then the Lord told Moses, now you will see what I will do, Pharaoh. When he feels the force of my strong hand, he will let the people go. In fact, he will force them to leave the land. God promised to do it, and he did. He is not a man that he should not lie. He did deliver the children of Israel. Yes. And that is just what he did at the Red Sea. He displayed his ultimate act of power.
Yes, sir.
See, we keep letting the enemy, trying to bring my voice back, we keep letting the enemy wreak havoc on us. We keep letting him run our lives. We keep telling him, let him tell us that we're nothing. We keep letting him put us in the corner. We keep letting him silence us. And we keep letting him tell us that we will never, ever, ever be anything. But we have to realize that we have the power within us to fight the enemy. Because God said in his word in Acts 7, 1 through 8, the Father alone has the authority to set those dates and times, and they are not for us to know. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses, telling people about me everywhere, in Jerusalem, throughout Judea, in Samaria, and to the ends of the world, and to the ends of the earth. In this passage, Jesus was talking to his disciples about the Holy Ghost, about the Comforter, about the Peacekeeper, about the Guider, about the Protector, about the ultimate power. Yeah. See, God can, he be often imitated, but never duplicated. So now we're going to talk about how to tap into that power. Mm-hmm. So let's look into power. Let's look at it in the natural state of where we live now. I looked it up and I studied and I looked at some things. In order for electricity or power, as we call it in natural state, in order for electricity to flow, there needs to be something that's pushing it, getting behind it to push to make the lights come on, to get help us to charge these fancy tablets and phones that we all love. For in order, even if we have electricity in our body, you know, when sometimes I guess when people they call flatline, they use the paddles of defibrillator. Then what are they doing? They're putting electricity into your body so that the electricity that's already in your body can respond and start your body back. So now let's look at this: hurt, pain, heartache, loneliness, letdowns, loss. God waking you up this morning. God keeping you in your right mind. God giving you the activity of your limbs. Put that power, that should always push or fuel your praise. Remember the natural state for electricity. For these lights to come on, when you flip that switch, something's got to push it, right? All right then. So now, the hurt, the pain, the heartache, even waking you up this morning, that should fuel or push your praise. Then your praise should flow or drive your worship. True worship. And once you get to true worship, then you will tap into the ultimate power. The power that God displayed at the Red Sea. See, let's look back at it. See, when I looked at, I studied Exodus, and I went through everything. I went back, and it said that God hardened Pharaoh's heart. How many times did he come to Pharaoh and say, let my people go? 9, I counted them. But each time, God hardened his heart. Why? Because he needed for Pharaoh and the children of Israel to know that I am God. And therefore, he had to display that ultimate act of power. So now, let's look at some power again. Again, electricity in the natural, as we refer to it. I also looked up and I seen that there is a simple equation that electricians use, which I didn't understand it, but their electricity, the way they calculate the way our power and electricity flows and works and pushes. So the equation was volts times amps equals watts. I don't get that. Anybody get that?
No.
I don't get that, because I'm not an electrician. I didn't go to school for it. I don't understand. But there is a simple equation that I do understand that can help us tap into the ultimate power, except the Father plus the Son plus the Holy Ghost. And what does that equal? The ultimate power. See, I didn't get the volts and the watts and the amps and this and the other. But now you break it down to me. Father plus the Son plus the Holy Ghost equals
the ultimate power. As long as we continue to tap that power, everything that the enemy has planned for us will not take place. Isaiah 43:2. When you go through the deep waters, I will be with you. Yeah. When you go through the rivers of difficulty, you will not drown. Yes. When you walk through the fire of oppression, you will not be burned up. Yes, the fumes, the flames will not consume you. Hallelujah. Yes, this scripture rings true to me because I've lived. Hallelujah. Yes. I have lived this scripture. Yes, I look back. Thank you, Jesus. Sometimes with Facebook, how it gives you your notifications of, you know, what you posted this time last year and what you posted this time, that whatever. This week, Facebook reminded me, and I don't know why I needed Facebook to remind me. One day this week was the anniversary of the year that I got electrocuted. I was electrocuted at work. Mm-hmm. Bent down in the safe to get something and touched something that was tore up in the wall, touched the cord, and volts shot out at me. Mm-hmm. Smoke, flame, burn my finger. Go back on the Facebook page and look at the pictures. Burn my finger. I lost 3 hours of time. And when you look back at the video, because the cameras were pointing right there, the flames and the smoke shot up over my head to where you couldn't see me in the camera anymore. When you walk through the fire of oppression, you will not be burned up. See, when we got to the emergency room, I couldn't even tell them how to unlock my phone, to call my husband, to call my parents, to get somebody. I knew nothing. I was out of it. When we got to the emergency room, the main concern was my heart. Now, they checked vitals. Everything was good. My breathing was good. I was sore in my arm from where the electricity went in and shot back out. But their main concern was my heart. Mm-hmm. See, when that much volts go in, it could stop your heart. It could damage your heart. It could have burned my heart. Uh-huh. And that's what they were concerned about. Mm-hmm. But what happened? I'm still here. Mm-hmm. But God said, not so, because I had tapped into the ultimate power. Mm-hmm. When you are tapped into the power, the total opposite happens with your heart. See, in the natural state, see, man were worried, they were worried about my heart being burned up, being blown up, being whatever else. But see, when you're in that ultimate power, the total opposite happens to your heart. See, God takes an old black sin-filled heart and he cleans it up and he makes it white as snow when you tap into that ultimate power. Not that power that came from the wall, but the ultimate power. Remember the Father plus the Son plus the Holy Ghost? He'll take that heart and he'll clean it up. Yeah. He'll make you pure. And have you ever noticed somebody that you see them 1 week and you want to avoid them, and that's something Pastor was talking about. But then you see them again a couple weeks later and you're looking at them and their face looks different. Mm-hmm. Their body language looks different. Mm-hmm. Their outfit is changed. They no longer look like they did last week, because what happened? They tapped into their ultimate power. Their walk changed. Yeah. Their talk changed. And sometimes you can't even figure it out, and you end up saying that there is just something about you. Yeah. I can't put my finger on it. Well, let me help you put your finger on it. They tapped into that ultimate power. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, when someone has tapped into the ultimate power, they will no longer be the same. Romans 12:2. Do not copy the behavior and the customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Then you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good, pleasing, and perfect. Perfect. High five your neighbor, or turn to your neighbor and tell him to tap that power. See, when God spoke to Moses and gave him the task of speaking to Pharaoh and the Egyptian, see, he didn't want the task. Right or wrong? Amen. He turned it down. I can't speak. I can't talk. I can't do it. And you know what? He thought his speech wasn't good enough. So God allowed Moses to use Aaron as his mouthpiece. When you tap into the ultimate power, things will come up in your life that will make you feel like Moses did. But I want to leave you with some encouragement. And I'm about done because my voice is giving out. Here's the encouragement. Keep tapping. When God has called you to a task, Isaiah 41:10. Don't be afraid, for I am with you. Yes, do not be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will hold you up with my victorious hand. Keep tapping. When you're feeling pushed beyond your own abilities, that will happen sometimes.
ultimate power. Ephesians 3:20. Now all glory to God, who is able through his mighty power at work within us to accomplish infinitely more than we can ask or think. Keep tapping. And when you need strength to keep tapping, because sometimes in this walk with Christ, we get weary. We want to give up because we don't see things moving and happening the way we think they should. Isaiah 40:29-31. He gives power to the weak and strength to the powerless. Even youth will become weak and tired, and young men will fall in exhaustion. But those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They will soar high like wings as eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. Keep tapping. Keep tapping. Ephesians 1:6. I am certain that God, who begun the good work in you, will continue his work until he's finally finished on the day when Christ returns. Never give up. Never give in. Keep tapping in the night when you're crying and you feel lonely and you feel like God is nowhere with you. Keep tapping. Keep tapping. Keep tapping. God is always with you. He sits high and he looks low. Keep tapping. Y'all keep tapping. God is often imitated, but he will never be duplicated. Keep tapping in the name of Jesus.